Earlier, I had mentioned how the league plans on announcing the salary cap details for next season, and it's going to be a quick turnaround to the announcement of the day in which the NBA teams can go after free agents. It's going to be probably a four-week turnaround. So this is where guys like Brock Aller is going to work his magic to make sure that we have a quick understanding of what guys we can go after, how the cap is going to look, added on with guys that we already have on the roster that we have to re-sign, and to put ourselves in a great position for next offseason, in which is the big free agency year, so we can go after big name guys. Now, I know what some of y'all are thinking, oh man, we ain't gonna get no free agents next season. But honestly, because of the pandemic and the financial position that some of these teams are in, we don't know what's really going on with some of these owners. Because like I said, some of their outside businesses are not doing well. And we never know what can really happen. Everything is about positioning right now. I mean, we've seen the last two NBA champions get crowned because they put themselves in a great position. We've seen the Lakers mentally put themselves in a great space to stay focused so they can position themselves to finish the bubble and to be in the finals. Unlike the Los Angeles Clippers, which their players were everywhere outside the bubble, doing all types of activities. They just never seemed focused all season. And then we've seen the Raptors last year put themselves in a position in which they could win the NBA championship and to take advantage of the Golden State Warriors having injuries. So sometimes, of course, you do need a little bit of luck, but sometimes things are just about positioning. And if the Knicks could position themselves with great free agency pickups this season at a good price this season, and have cap flexibility for next season, we could position ourselves. We never know what a disgruntled star. It could be Kawhi Leonard. Because the Clippers this year are under pressure to win now. And if they have another blow up, who knows? Guys might be willing to walk. And in us being able to land a guy like that, we could attract other guys because we're in position. So as far as this year's free agency, the key thing is going to be to get guys at a great price. Because the Knicks, the Hawks, and the Pistons will set the tone to how much money is being spent this offseason when it comes to free agency. The Hawks are number one with the spending money. We all know they want to make the playoffs next year. They already said that. They're not really aiming to be a rebuilding team for the next couple of seasons or even the next season. But the key thing is that us and those other two teams are going to pretty much set the tone to how much money is being spent in free agency. And this season might be the season where it comes down to negotiation skills. And it might even come down to which teams don't make a move. That's an underestimated card right there. Whoever doesn't really make a move may end up being a winner. Because, of course, this year's free agents, they're pretty good, especially guys like Fred VanVleet that can complete our roster and help guys like RJ Barrett actually play better in stride because he doesn't have to play out of position. But at the same time, a lot of these free agents this season are not really game changers. They could help the teams, but they're not really game changers like the next offseason. So with the league trying to set the salary cap in early November and then make the quick turnaround to announce the NBA free agency start date in early December, it leaves that short window for the new hires that Leon Rose picked, particularly guys like Brock Aller, to work the numbers and to figure out under this new salary cap, what advantages and disadvantages do we have and what are our better options? Should we make trades? Should we stick to rebuilding? Or could we sign guys this offseason at a certain price point to leave ourselves flexible for the next offseason in which we can go after the game changers? This is where I believe that hire that Leon Rose made of getting Brock Aller is going to pay off for the Knicks right here. Because Brock Aller, man, for him to work that salary cap that last season that LeBron was there to make all them damn trades and those guys still be under a certain threshold, that guy was working numbers, man. He was working miracles. And it's fucking amazing that we got a guy like this part of the organization. Especially at a time like this where the league's numbers are in flux, the salary cap is unknown. Man, times like this are designed for guys like Brock Aller to thrive.